This video is going to show how to build a Silverlight business application using RIA services and SQL Server to display an org chart diagram of employees in the AdventureWorks sample database. To build the org chart, we are going to use the GoXam diagram control from Northwood's software. This demo is based on tutorials on the Silverlight.net site that show how to build a business application with a data grid. If you're not familiar with Silverlight business application development, you may want to start with the Silverlight.net tutorials, as we're going to go through that part pretty quickly. If you are watching this on YouTube, be sure to pick the 720p HD button on the bottom there and click the expand button to get the video at the right size. First, using Visual Studio 2010, create a Silverlight business application project. And we'll call that Business Application 7. This generates a client-server application. And first, we're going to work on the server side to add data access. We will add a data model, an ADO.NET entity data model, and we're going to call this AdventureWorks data model. We're going to generate from the database. For the data connection, I've already set up access to the AdventureWorks sample database. And this will pull the objects out of the database. The Silverlight.net tutorials use tables. We're going to use one of the predefined views. The employee department view has almost all the data we need for an org chart: employee name, title, group, etc. And we've made one minor change to this. We've added the manager ID to this view, and you'll see why in a second. The employee department record has an employee ID, which is the ID of this record. And the manager ID is the ID of the employee, which is that employee's boss. So that those two things give us the information we need to build an org chart tree. So now we will rebuild the solution. And now we need to add a service that can access that data. So we're going to go to web and add a domain service class. And we're going to call that the Adventure Domain Service. And add that. We're going to include the employee department record and generate that and do a rebuild solution. Okay, now that gives us all that we need on the server side to pull the data out for the clients. So now we're going to switch to the Silverlight client side. And rather than create a new page, we're just going to use the home page that was generated as part of the template. Now we're going to take a shortcut here. In order to set up the data source, we're going to drag a data grid onto our page. And we're going to then go to the Data Sources tab. And here's our AdventureWorks domain context, we have an employee department data source. So we're going to drop that on the data grid. And now I'm going to switch to the XAML view so we can see the code that's been added. This has added the data grid control and the RIA control for accessing the data, the domain data source, and the loaded data event handler and the name and the query. The query is get employee department query. Okay, that was the part that we needed. We don't really need the data grid, so what we're going to do is we're going to delete that. And we're going to switch back to design view and go back to our toolbox and grab the diagram control and bring that over. and drop that in there. Now it's right there. We will do a couple of things here. We will set the min height. And now we have the data source here. We need to tell the diagram how to read the data. And we do that with a model in GoXam. So we're going to add a diagram model to the diagram declaration. GoXam has several different data models to support automatic data binding, depending on the complexity of your graph data. But for a simple org chart tree, we're going to use the universal tree model. Node key path is employee ID, and the parent node path is manager ID. So now we've told the diagram the data it is binding to is a tree, where the employee represents the node and the manager ID represents a link to the manager node. But we need to tell the diagram where the data is coming from. So we're going to go to the loaded data event that happens when the data has been loaded from the database. Diagram one dot nodes source, which is like item source, is equal to v employee domain source dot data. Okay. Now we have a complete program, and we're going to run this. Okay. Now this doesn't look a lot like an org chart yet. What we're seeing here is the nodes are being created by each employee record, just doing a .toString because we haven't told GoDiagram what the node layout is supposed to be yet. We're going to do that next. And we also haven't told it, we've told it that it's the data is structured like a tree, but we haven't told the diagram itself to lay out like a tree. So let's go do those two things now. We're going to go in here into the diagram, and we're going to paste a little XAML in here that tells the diagram how to lay out the nodes. And what we're specifying here is a tree layout with various parameters, one of which says do a bus layout on the final children in the tree. We'll see more of that later. Now we need to tell the diagram what a node looks like, and we do that with a XAML data template. I've pasted that in here. Each node is defined by a data template that defines its appearance and behavior. This node here has a simple border, and within that border, a stack panel containing three text blocks. The first text block uses data binding to retrieve the first name from the employee record, followed by a space, and then the last name. And now we go down to the diagram control, and we say, node template equals static resource node template. And that references this right here. And now we will run the program. And we will have a real tree layout. And we'll have a very simple node with a name in it. Now note, we mentioned the bus layout there earlier. This is the bus layout. The bottom children in this particular tree layout are laid out like this. Now, there's one more thing that we could do here. We could make the links look a little more like an org chart. And let me go back and do that. So we'll close this. We'll go back to the grid resources. And we'll add another data template, which is the link template that is an orthogonal link routing with a corner of 3. We'll go back down to the diagram and we'll say link template is a static resource, link template. And one more time we'll run the program. there you go, that looks a little better. Now, we've gone from web service to running Silverlight application, doing an org chart in under 10 minutes here. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. We plan to have more videos in this series that show more interesting node templates, updating the underlying SQL data interactively, collapse and expand on subtrees, something a graph this wide obviously needs, and perhaps some more advanced Silverlight things after that. Northwood Software has been doing diagram controls for more than 15 years, and to be honest, we're very excited about GoXam. It's just a very cool product. Note I just did this whole application by writing a single line of C# code. You won't find a diagram control for WPF or Silverlight that is a more complete and integrated extension of XAML than GoXam. One thing you'll see is how it creates a very liquid user interface where changes to the diagram are animated from one state to the next. This aids the user's understanding of the state changes as well as just being an expected feature of modern user interfaces. There's a full evaluation kit on our website with a huge selection of sample programs. And because we understand you may be more than 15 days or 30 days away from a decision on even whether to use a diagram in your product, there's no time limit on our eval. Check it out today. Thanks again.